Hello and welcome to the 11 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Shoaib Mohammed. The representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of the Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, deputized the Minister of Youth and Sports Affairs, Hisham bin Mohammed Al Joder, to inaugurate the 8th edition of Youth City 2030. And for the first time in the history of the event, a robot named Titan gave the introductory tour of the city and its various centres. Sheikh Nasser affirmed that the support of His Majesty the King to the youth of Bahrain motivates them to participate in building the kingdom's establishments. His Highness noted that Bahrain has always placed youth among its top priorities as part of its effort to develop future leaders who will become the solid foundation of the kingdom's development. He noted that Youth City 2030 is one of the leading programs in building the character of Bahraini youth, affirming that it's part of the programs and activities that the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports has directed to establish. His Highness added that the event combines the needs of young people from different categories and the needs of the labor market by providing excellent training programs and opportunities that enhance youth skills by taking advantage of the programs offered this year. His Highness Sheikh Nasser hailed the role of Minister Hisham Al Joder and all the ministry's cadres in the success of Youth City, noting the support of Temkeen, which reflects its strategy of developing Bahraini youth capabilities. For his part, Minister Joder affirmed that His Highness Sheikh Nasser's keenness in supporting Youth City 2030 proves his interest in the youth, asserting that His Highness is aware of the importance of youth to the kingdom's comprehensive development. Temkeen's Chief Executive Officer, Dr. Ibrahim Mohammed Janahi, stated that Temkeen prioritizes preparing and qualifying the youth to enter the labor market by stimulating it through programs during the period of Youth City 2030.
Youth City 2030 held an opening ceremony for its 8th edition of the program at the Bahrain International Exhibition and Convention Center.
Well, what we do usually in Youth City 2030 is we open the opportunity for kids and youth mostly to apply to be able to, you know, build their skill set for their careers. So this year with Youth City 2030, what we have done is we have added new additions to the city itself in which we have focused on sports and nutrition as well, which has been, which we have not really focused on the years before, but we are definitely making a big impression hopefully this year. And we hope that for the years to come, we continue to improve on the many programs that we are offering for the youth.
The opening ceremony was attended by state officials, Supreme Council for Youth and Sport members, and GOIS officials, and featured a tour of the space led by a robot.
We are like around 8 years partners with the ministry, and it's a strategic kind of project that cater, let's say, the talent in Bahrain. It gives opportunity for, let's say, the youth to showcase their talents and maybe shape up their personalities for the future.
It's a brilliant initiative that has been running for 8 years and 8 consecutive years. This year has been really impressive. Each year is even better than the year before. But this year, the sustainability theme that they've initiated in this program is really impressive. And we've been really impressed with the amount of work and the programs that they've developed in this year's initiative.
The 8th edition of the Youth City 2030 is a platform that this year aims to promote creative thinking among outstanding Bahraini youth and to enrich their expertise and talent.
Youth City 2030 highlights Bahrain's role as a pioneer, allowing Bahrain's youth to join the labor market in a unique way. Reporting for Bahrain International, I'm Yasmin Ibrahim.
Speaker of the Representatives Council, Ahmed Al-Mulla, chaired today the weekly meeting and expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al-Khalifa for his continuous support to the parliamentary work and keenness to provide the best services to the country and people. He also extended appreciation to the government led by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al-Khalifa, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al-Khalifa and the council members. The council approved 2 draft laws regarding the amendments of the Financial Control Bureau Law and Commercial Companies Laws and another draft law regarding the organization of registration of births and deaths. The council approved a number of proposals, including the proposal to grant the patient's first degree relatives who are employees with a 1-month paid leave in Bahrain and no more than 4 months outside Bahrain, the proposal to increase the number of inspectors in the services sectors, the proposal for the government to set up a committee of qualified cadres to study negative phenomena in the community, the proposal to allocate a budget for the embassies of the Kingdom of Bahrain abroad for the treatment of emergency cases, the proposal for the government to prepare a strategy to deal with the file reorientation of direct and indirect government supports and the review and development of the state's financial resources, the proposal to support the activities and programs carried out by the tourism sector in the kingdom, the proposal for a new government-established security body out of the Ministry of Interior to protect the national carrier aircraft from abductions and terrorism, the proposal to designate an authority responsible for controlling the import, export, distribution, sale or supply of chemicals in Bahrain, the proposal to increase cadres and provide a suitable building for the licensing and certification section of the Criminal Information Department, the Services Committee reports regarding the proposal to establish an integrated village for traditional Bahraini craftsmanship and display, including ships, the proposal to establish a hospital for alternative medicine with the participation of the private sector, the proposal for the transfer of patients of complexes 929, 931 and 939 from the 4th District in the Southern Governorate to receive treatment at the Hamad Kano Health Centre, an amended proposal on the establishment of an information policy to counter campaigns that distort the image of the Kingdom of Bahrain in international forums, the proposal for the government to invest in the medical field, the proposal to build multi-story car parks and increase the parking space allocated to King Hamad University Hospital, the proposal for the government represented by the Ministry of Works, Municipal Affairs and Urban Planning to complete the urban development projects in Karbabad, the proposal to allocate housing projects for Northern Sahila citizens as well as Abu Ghuwa and Jablat Habshi, the proposal to allocate a coastal area for fishermen in the Mhara Governorate, the proposal to reduce the municipal fees of unmarried Bahraini women that have no dependents and no fixed income, the proposal to allow the private sector to establish family hotel apartments in the Rafah area. The council also approved proposals regarding adapting strategies for kidney transplant for kidney failure patients, conducting workshops on first aid and household safety for government sector employees, setting new curriculum for the first and second levels of kindergarten that promote national identity. The approvals included proposals on establishing a new aviation company, developing roads in Senobis, developing Al Arin Wildlife Park and establishing various playgrounds in residential areas. The meeting also approved naming one of the main streets in Bahrain after the custodian of the two holy mosques, King Salman bin Abdulaziz Al Saud. It also approved allocating 5% of each housing project for people with disabilities and approved the government's ban on acquisition of Al Lawzi Lake or transferring it into any project. The council then issued a statement denouncing closing Al Aqsa Mosque and the arbitrary measures taken by the Israeli authorities against the Palestinian people, calling upon the international community to take its role and responsibility.